Hey, what's up, YouTubers? This is SP Jackie back again today with another Clash Royale video, and today I'm gonna show you again the Royal Giant strategy because Royal Giant is now so overpowered. So let's check the deck over here. You will come to know how the deck is. It's the first content Royal Giant, Arrows, Skeleton Tombstone, Fireball, Barbarians, Fireball, and Archers, Goblins, and the Melee Goblins, Melee Spear, Skeleton, sorry for that. So let's check some replays. So yeah, first of all, we are facing with someone who having minority. So legendary card, first of all, facing with a legendary card. Right now, I'm basically waiting for my elixir to get filled, and even he's waiting for his elixir to get filled. So he's doing going for the minor, and I'm going with the skilled army. That was a great placement of my skilled army, as it would distract the minor, and the minor would be going down very easily. The minor is one of the great units in Clash Royale, but yes, it can be taken out very easily if you are knowing it well. Now he's going with a wizard, and wizard is also a very great counter to attack as well as going on with a push. Right now we did some bad damage to his tower. So he's going with the P.E.K.K.A. first. This deck works against P.E.K.K.A., golems, as well as all the legendary cards except the Sparky. I never faced a Sparky with this deck, but yes, if I face one, I will just share a replay. I have faced Sparky many times, but I have done better strategy on it, and I have beat many Sparky decks. So right now he's pushing back with the P.E.K.K.A. and the Archers army. This is one of the great army I've ever seen, because Archers are so versatile that they can attack very easily to any small units. So right now we are taking out this P.E.K.K.A. and displacing that Wallbreaker, whatever you want to say. But yes, this Bomber is doing a great amount of damage, and now I place the Royal Giant. Royal Giant is so overpowered, guys. He is doing a good damage to that tower. Right now these barbarians are very much easily countered, and he's trying to push with the minion miner, and the miner is easily distracted by all the units over to there. So he's done a very great amount of damage. So I placed the Tombstone Horde. Tombstone Horde, it can distract minion hordes, even Hog Rider, and take the Hog Rider freeze combo very easily. So right now he's doing another P.E.K.K.A. push, and he's coming back with a P.E.K.K.A. I'm waiting for my elixir to get filled so that I could take out that P.E.K.K.A. easily. His Wall Bomber is going to do a great amount of damage to that P.E.K.K.A. Right now he's pushing back with the Wizard P.E.K.K.A. army. I was ready with the Fireball first, and then Arrows need Fireball. This is one of the things I showed in my previous video, how to counter with Wizard like this. If you are using Fireball of low level like this, you should go for the Arrows Fireball first and then arrow him. You'll definitely go down. Right now he's trying to pushing hard to be, but this P.E.K.K.A. is going to go down surely because he's not at a good health, and he is going to be distracted by a lot of units over to here. And he's trying to push back again with a Miner. Miner is going to go down very easily, doing some pretty good damage to my tower. Right now you guys can see I'm trying to push back again, saving my elixir, and done with that Royal Giant. So he's trying to counter me with that Mega P.E.K.K.A. P.E.K.K.A. can do a great amount of damage to Royal Giant, but this Royal Giant is doing a versatile damage to this P.E.K.K.A. Now placing all the small units over here. So he's trying to pushing back towards me. Right now I fireball all the units, and this fireball taking a lot kinds of units over there, and this P.E.K.K.A. is literally going to go down. He's placing another Bomber, and this Bomber is doing a great damage to that Wallbreaker, so Barbarian army. Right now he's placing the Bomber with a Barbarian. This is one of the strategy I've ever seen in Clash Royale, using very lots of players using this. This video was recorded earlier. I'm at literally now 2400 trophies with this strategy, and this tower is going to go down surely because this Royal Giant is going to do a great amount of damage, and just a fireball would be necessary to take him down with the next push. Right now he's trying to push back again with the Miner, and Miner is doing a great amount of damage, but yes, this Miner is just a level 1. He's not gonna do that amount of damage as considered to the level 4 or level 3 Miner. So no, I've never seen a level 3 or level 2 Miner even. So White Knight is trying to push again, and he's doing a great push over here, but this arrow is going to take all the units down. He's trying to push again with the Miner. So I'm trying to go for the Royal Giant. Royal Giant is distracted towards that elixir pump, but yes, he's going to go and take out that elixir pump easily. I'm gonna move over towards the right tower, and there we are. He count distracted towards the right tower, and he's going to take them out before the fireball, and there comes a smiley laugh towards him and he's crying. Okay, so let's move on to another replay, and you will come to know how the deck is pretty awesome. So right now we are facing Amin Hussein from Khan Iran, and he's bringing that Hog Rider Goblin and a Minion Horde combo, Goblin Barrel and a Minion Horde combo. This is one of the great combos I've ever seen in Clash Royale, because it just waste your arrows on Goblin Barrel or waste your arrows on Minion or whatever. The great thing how to be do by these players is that you actually distract your players. Now I'm giving a smile because I know I have those arrows with me, but you don't know that. So we're going to push with the Hog Rider, but I'm placing my Royal Giant in the front to make this Hog Rider a little bit slow. and it's not arrowing my troops, and this is one of the great thing I've ever seen, because arrowing may have taken out that Skeleton army and moved out the Hog would have done a great amount of damage. Right now, you might have lost his connection. I don't know what happened to him, but this tower is literally going to go down, and he placed the minion very late, and this tower is down. Okay, he's placing the minion so late, and he's now very much angry over to me, seems to be, because he's placing that minion so late, and yes, he's showing that angry face, knowing that he was angry, because I think so his connection went away or something like that. But yes, okay, that's advantage for me. So I'm just waiting for my elixir, he's going for the golem. I just giving him merciless love because I don't care of golem. The golem are so versatile and they can be taken out very easily if you know how to take them out. And right now I'm placing a small skeleton army to bring my more important troop, and he uses arrows on them. Seems to be he's not using the arrows on them. He's using the Hog Rider again and placing the barbarians. Barbarians are gonna do a great amount of damage to Hog Rider as well as the melee goblins as well as the golem. The golem is going to burst into small pieces and he's going to do a great amount of damage. It's one of the great combos. I have to use it if I want to, but yes, these small units, he might have arrowed him. Why don't he arrow him? I don't know, but yes, he's placing that Valkyries, and this Valkyrie is going to take these units out very easily. He's placing this minion node. I just arrowed this minion node, and right now his Valkyries is very in a great danger because he's just in a few health. So he's placing another goblin barrel. I'm going to place that fireball and take this goblin barrel out. So my tower is literally in a bad hell. He's trying to push with your left lane, thinking of that he might do damage onto my next tower to take a great crown, one crown green. But yes, I'm going to push again because I need to push back, and he's trying to come back with the archers. I've seen players doing this a lot of time because archers are so great. If you are using them very perfectly, they can actually move on with the tanking unit and it can take out units very easily. Right now, I arrow this minion horde, and the Royal Giant has done a great amount of damage to the tower. So that's what I'm saying. Every time, Royal Giant can do a great amount of damage if you are using it very properly. As golems are not good, golems can be good, but yes, they are easily distracted. They are very much high power unit, but yes, they can just be distracted by small things and even buildings, so it can be there. Barbarians even can take it out easily. So right now, placing the Royal Giant into the arena, I'm placing a little bit cheeky move to place that Royal Giant here, and this Royal Giant is going to do a great amount of damage, and we're gonna fireball and arrow this fireball, and that fireball will be leading him us to victory. There we are, giving him a merciless laugh, and he's angry. yeah, come on, you are angry, what should I do? So let's move on to last replay. In this replay, the player uses Princess over to me, and now Princess is so good unit. I have just faced the Princess, and you're gonna check it out. If a Princess is not touched, how much damage he can do to a tower. So right now, I'm placing the Elixir Palm. I'm gonna place my small unit in an army to take, just bring my most important unit into the front. And right now he's doing a great patient waiting for his elixir to get filled. He plays a cannon. Cannon are so versatile defense. Now these cannons are so distracted, create so much destruction for Hog, golems and something. And it's just a 3 elixir cost and does a great amount of damage. Right now he's placing the princess. And check it out, guys. If you're not taking a great care of princess, this princess can do a great amount of damage, as it does very great amount of damage to my tower, as I didn't touch his princess, and that was one of my great bad decision of not arrowing them. I was thinking that he was having those minion horde or something like that, but it has the minion horde, but he doesn't have those minion horde. Seems to be from the first few seconds I thought that he might be having that minion horde, so I didn't use my arrows on that princess. Right now he's placing another elixir pump to get that elixir arrow, and these elixir pumps are good, but if they only produce one elixir, so that's a waste of a pie elixir, and that's just a waste of a time even. So right now I'm placing the princess from the back, thinking that I know that I don't have arrows, and placing the spear goblins with him to take a care of these melee goblins. So I place the arrows and he's gonna take down the princess as well as the small unit. Right now placing the barbarians in the front. I have this wall breaker to take him out, and this wall breaker is going to do great amount of damage. As he's placing the wild giant, Royal Giant can be easily distracted with that skeleton tombstone. Right now I'm placing my Royal Giant towards the left, and he's distracted by the cannon. Cannon is so versatile, I say it every time, cannon is so dangerous, you cannot believe. And right now this cannon is done a good amount of damage, but this Royal Giant is going to do also a great amount of damage. Right now I'm placing that archer arrows to that princess, because princess can do a great amount of damage if doesn't care. If you don't care about that princess, I didn't have any legendary cards. I'm not happy with that because I'm in Royal Arena, almost 2,437 trophies right now. This video was recorded earlier still not a legendary card, not even a one legendary card, not even a prize winner or something like that. Don't know, Supercell hate me or like that. But yes, I get good amount of common cards, rare cards, but not a legendary card even. So right now he's trying to distract my Royal Jan with a ball breaker, sorry, with a cannon in the front, but this cannon is going to go down and this Royal Jan is going to do great amount of damage. As he places Princess again, Princess is giving easily counter with the arrows, but you need a level 8 arrow, so my arrows are level 8. If you don't have level 8 arrows, you cannot distract, you cannot take the Princess fully, because you're gonna have some free health remaining into him, because level 7 arrow does not deal great damage to the Princess. Right now I'm in a good position, as I can see that this tower has a great amount of health remaining. I'm gonna fireball this area, and he's trying to push back towards the right lane. Just few hits remaining, guys. This is so much denser. Right now he's pushing with the Royal Jan. Royal Jan is attracted towards my tower. I'm waiting for my arrows, but the Royal Jan is pushed back towards the Royal Tombstone, and there we are, this arrow, and there we go, merciless laugh. Thanks for watching this today's video. Don't forget to like, subscribe and comment. This is Epic Life Clash, is gonna bring more much video regarding Clash Royale and Clash of Clans. Thanks for watching.